the address translation process. And the reason the translation has to happen is because process thinks it has this big address space, contiguous going from zero through some max. And then we said, well, the physical memory, one process may not have all of it at the same time, or physical memory may be much smaller than the address space size itself. So logical address or virtual address is actually going to be different from the physical address that we're talking about. So this is actually, if you think about it, this is a logical address here. And addresses that we have here are going to be addresses into physical memory. Okay? That's your real memory that you have in the system. So what we're going to do is we're saying, well, this part is going here, that part is going here. So maybe one goes at the top here, maybe three goes down here and things like that. We said we have to take data and code that is in the address space and we have to place that into physical memory. Okay, the way we sort of do that is we don't want to do it for each byte or each word because we'll have to keep track of what's going where. Okay, so one way to scale that process is that we divide this address space and the memory into some size chunks. Okay, so if you do paging, it's divided into what's called pages. A page typically may be 4 kilobytes, for example, 4K size. So we would say, well, the address space really is a page number and displacement within that page. So this is page 0, and if you location 10, then it's page 0, comma, 10. Okay, so 0 is the page, and 10 is displacement within that page. If your address happens to be, let's say, 4K plus 3, then it's going to be the second page because second page starts at 4K. First 0 through 4K minus goes in page, the first page, and then the second one starts. So then we'll say it's page 2 and maybe displacement 5 or 2 or whatever it is. So the logical address, you can think of that as a page number and a displacement. Essentially, a page table says this. It is a mapping, isn't it? So it says this logical page is currently stored in this physical page. Okay, so if I want to think about a page table, essentially a page table, we have all these entries and it's logical page 0, 1, 2. We're saying, you know, this may be at 3, this may be at 5, this may be at 8. And maybe 3 is currently not loaded. Virtual memory, not everything is in memory at the same time. So this is a page table that actually we build, and the operating system is responsible for actually building this and protecting this. Remember, at this point, sort of a flow that we should understand is really important. A process may be executing in user space, generates an address, okay, saying I need to fetch the next instruction. That's where my instruction pointer, program counter points, or an operand or whatever it is, and I need to access this memory location. It sort of starts with a logical address. The system now says, well, where exactly is this information that the process needs? We need to locate the physical address to which this logical address maps. For that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the logical address page number, and I'm going to look up this page table. Okay, so this address translation requires that you access this page table, and there are ways to speed this whole process up. So I'm saying if the page number is 3, or let's say the page number is 2, then I go down here and I say, oh, it's in physical memory page 8. So the address that we have, if it's 3 and some displacement D, could translate to 8 and the same displacement. So it's say memory page 8 and go down in D locations or D bytes in that. This is what is called the address translation process. So the important observation here is that we can only access physical memory that is reachable through this page table that we have for this process. I should say page tables are a lot more complicated, multi-level, you know, things like that, but let's just sort of stay with this basic idea of how they help us get this isolation, which is important to us, because the process has to start with an address. Address has to be translated. Translation is only possible through this page table. So whatever the page table points to is all a process can access. Another observation here that we should be clearly understanding is that the page tables have to be maintained by the operating system. They have to be managed by the trusted computing base, because whatever goes into the page table, we can access that. So the operating system should make sure that whatever goes in the page table of a particular process is only memory that belongs to that process. So that's the address translation. It gives you a little bit more information about what part of memory a given process is able to access, and that's it relates to this isolation thing that we've been talking about.